Now, in continuation of last video lecture of nylon 6 polymerization processes, in which the next polymerization process is continuous polymerization process, it is also named as, or more popularly known as, VK tube process. VK dot, it is stands for wherein fetch it contain your leach. A German word and more commonly termed named is wherein fetch it contain your leach, which simply means that in the German language its meaning is a continuous, and more popularly abbreviated as VK tube process. The VK tube is 8 to 10 meter high and its diameter is 2 to 3 meter, depends on the required production, means the dimensions of height or diameter can be changed depend on the production capacity. The tube is made by assembling the several sections. You can see in this diagram the design of a VK tube, in which from the on the top it is divided into three sections. See, John first, John second, or John third, means that there are the three section: top section, middle section, or bottom section. In the top section, there various inlets and outlets are available. The molten caprolactam is fed continuously, and this required quantity of water is also fed to this one. And one outlet in which the water or the vapor, unconverted caprolactam vapors with oligomers, are a small quantity of caprolactam, you can see, not always, but maybe it can be removed at by the condenser, but it is mostly the water is removed. And you can see here the nitrogen gas is, means the chemical reaction or the polymerization reaction takes place in presence of nitrogen atmosphere. Every section is double jacketed and having its own heating system. And you can see here the baffle plates, or in, you can see the, it provides the zigzag path. Yes, you can see here the each section has its own heating system and control. The top of the tube serves as a feed zone and fitted with reflux system, and several inlet and outlet pipes are provided for feed and outgoing vapors. And there is also a feed pipe for an nitrogen gas, act as a blanket preventing the thermo-oxidative degradation due to air. Now, melted caprolactam, means caprolactam already melt, means the caprolactam separately melt and then feed with stabilizers and small quantity of water, say 1 to 5%, depend on the you can say the industrial practices. Okay, how much amount of water wants to use as a catalyst, and small quantity of titanium dioxide as a delustering agent are fed to the tube continuously by metering pump. And then the temperature of the top zone is kept 250 to 270 degrees centigrade, and boiling of water starts at this temperature. And due to that agitation at the top zone, because of boiling, the agitation already, means mixing is carried out, agitating by boiling is carried out, and inclined baffle plates are placed in the tube, which decide the passage of melt in a zigzag manner, means the passage of the molten mass with water for caprolactam is zigzag. And during the passage of the melt in the tube, caprolactam ring opens, means first the hydrolysis take place on the top of the on the top section of the this VK tube, and it get convert into aminocaproic acid, that is ACA, and which initiates the polymerization reaction, and the water liberated from the polycondensation reaction means after the ring opening in the continuation of this top or at the middle section, the pre-polymerization starts and that liberates a small quantity of water, and as the material propagate or you can say move ahead in the by the through the various baffle plate path in the zigzag manner, the polycondensation is carried out, and from the reaction system in the form of vapors which bubble out of the melt, favoring the further polycondensation reaction, and by the time the melt reaches the at the bottom of the tube is fully polymerized and is withdrawn at a constant rate and with the help of a metering pump. And solidified in the water bath cooled, and finally ribbon is cut into chips, and from top to bottom flow of molten mass is required 20 to 24 hours for complete reaction. Now it is very important to understand here in the bottom at the last, the polymer mass is extruded in a cooling bath or casting weight, and these casting weight polymer ribbon, casted polymer ribbon is solidified and go for the chips cutting. Now it is the means of the continuity is get lost, you can say here, because the polymer mass do not go directly for the spinning while it so get converted into solid ribbon and cut into chips. Now same as like the batch process, these chips are rich with unconverted caprolactam as well as small quantity of oligomers. Now these polymer chips before go to the spinning or before go to the drying and final spinning, these chips the caprolactam unconverted mass must be removed, and for that a counter current multi-stage washing means multi-stage more than one, you can say, or you can say that 4 or 5 washing tanks are used. You can see here from one side the chips are fed in a first washing bath, and from another side the washed chips, and here you can see the fresh water from this side and fresh water from last section to last tank to the second last. You can see here I shown in this diagram that there are the 5 tanks, and you can see here from first tank here, you can see this is the first tank from which the fresh water is filled, then this fresh water is transferred to the next tank in the where the small amount of Cl is removed. But you can see here this is the first tank, you can see where maximum Cl is removed. You can see here the nylon 6 polymer chips contain 90% PCl, 8 to 9% caprolactam unconverted mass, and 2 to 3% oligomers, and the chips are subjected to a counter current water wash, and at 95 degree centigrade temperature for the removal of caprolactam, and this is necessary as it prevents the post polymerization during melt spinning. The residual caprolactam is removed from polymer in the following manner: after first wash, the मतलब आफ्टर फर्स्ट वॉश 5% कैप्रोलेक्टम इज रिमूव्ड, इन सेकेंड वॉश 2 to 5% कैप्रोलेक्टम इज रिमूव्ड, इन द थर्ड टैंक 1 to 1.5% कैप्रोलेक्टम इज रिमूव्ड, इन द फोर्थ वॉश 0.5% और रेजिडुअल कैप्रोलेक्टम इज रिमूव्ड. सो द कैप्रोलेक्टम रिच वॉश वाटर इज सेंट टू रिसाइकलिंग प्लांट. देन वॉश्ड पॉलीमर चिप्स आर गो फॉर ड्राइंग द प्रोसेस, एंड द नाइलॉन 6 चिप्स आर ड्राइड इन ए रोटेटरी ड्रम ड्रायर्स विच इज रोटेटिंग एट वेरी स्लो स्पीड ऑफ 5 RPM एंड ऑपरेटिंग एट 100 or 120 degree centigrade टेम्परेचर फॉर 20 to 50 hours इन नाइट्रोजन एटमोसफियर. द ड्राइड चिप्स आर हैव मॉइस्चर कंटेंट मस्ट बी बिलो देन 0.02 to 0.04%. इफ हायर देन हायर मॉइस्चर मॉलिक्यूल्स रिमेन प्रेजेंट इन द पॉलीमर मास एट द टाइम ऑफ स्पिनिंग दीज मे बी कॉज ऑफ हाइड्रोलिसिस डिग्रेडेशन. नाउ वन मोर मॉडिफाइड और एक्चुअल मीन्स ऑफ द कंटिन्यूस प्रोसेस यू कैन सी इन दिस नेक्स्ट डिस्कशन. हियर इंटीग्रेटेड कंटिन्यूस प्रोसेस दिस इज ए मॉडिफाइड फॉर्म ऑफ द कन्वेंशनल वीके ट्यूब मेथड. द मॉडिफिकेशन इज एम्ड टू एट रिमूविंग द मोनोमर एंड ओलिगोमर्स फ्रॉम द मेल्ट, एंड फॉर दिस द मेल्ट फ्रॉम द वीके ट्यूब is spread over a large surface. Yes, mold is the polymer mass of nylon 6 as formed by the polymerizer is spread over a large surface area in the thin film form, and this is used as a evaporator and operating under vacuum, and this operation remove the residual monomer and quickly eliminates the subsequent process of washing, drying and remelting of chips. Means the actual means of continuity can be achieved by this modified designs of VK tube. You can see here the pre-polymerizer where the pressure is kept more than 1 atm pressure. Means here you can see the caprolactam and water is fed to this one, and here the ring opening and pre-polymerization takes place where the small size PCL molecules are fed to the next vessel where the polycondensation reactor, you can say, and also the water is removed, and for that the vacuum is applied, or you can say pressure is below than 1 atm pressure is kept, and water vapor is removed at this, and the molten mass is which is rich with molten mass means the molten mass is nylon 6 polymer which is rich with small quantity of unconverted caprolactam as well as oligomers, and here small still having some water is transported to the next vessel where this is a falling film evaporator. Means the molten mass in the form of very thin film, and it is moving from top to downward direction of this vessel, and you can see here the water vapor is removed with monomer removal. But it is important to note that here it is named as integrated continuous process, but here if we are comparing with the conventional VK tube, the polymer chips are completely free from the caprolactam, but here in this polymer mass, as you can say here, no need to convert into the chips, directly fed to the spinning cabinet, but having very small quantity of say 1 to 2% Cl still remain present in the polymer. molten mass. So that's why this is the difference between the VK tube and modified integrated continuous process. These are all these three: batch process, continuous process, and modified continuous process. Thank you.